Watch this show. You may have a piece of rugby league history that you've forgotten all about. It might be in your garage or up in the attic or in a box somewhere. Well, on The Fan, we want to uncover the lot. That's why we've ripped off this. Now, the biggest collection of rugby league stuff I've ever come across belongs to a guy by the name of Dan Payne. He has a business, Dan's NRL Collectibles. And on The Fan, he's going to appraise items for us this year. Here he is. G'day, Dan.
Oh, hello, Bossy.
Now, The Fan's have been great since last week. We're in promo on our first show that we've got, the Rugby League Antiques Roadshow. And the first item is from Jim of Mossvale, Southern Highlands of New South Wales. Have a look at this. A Balmain Tigers ashtray.
Oh,
what do you think, mate?
Wow, this is brilliant.
Yeah.
I've had one of these for a long time.
Okay, what year is that from?
That's from 1988, the grand final year, and they made a special one with a gold tinge on it.
Wow, where would this have been made?
China.
Okay, anywhere in particular?
Guangzhou Province.
Of course, big fans there. What would Jim have paid for this in 1988?
These retailed for $2.50 at the time.
And what would it be worth then?
Oh, on the collector's market, $2.75 up to $3.
Right, okay, fantastic. All right, now you've got a wonderful piece from your own collection. This is a wonderful piece of rugby league history that you've recently acquired. A New South Wales jersey, as worn in the 1950 series.
Yeah, that's correct. This is Frank Steenwall's New South Wales jersey.
He was 5'8".
Yeah, and he played 3 interstate matches and also won against Great Britain in this jersey.
So he wore the same jersey in every game. They had to take it home and wash it,
yeah,
and then come back with it.
That's correct.
That's extraordinary. And you said he's 5'8", but the number on the back is the number 8.
So in 1950, the front rower was number 1. And the fullback was 13, making the 5'8", number 8.
Amazing. So how much would this be worth?
Well, this is a very sentimental piece. It's his only one, and he went on to play for Australia that year. So something like this is worth about $2,000 to $3,000.
That is absolutely fantastic.
Feel free to share with us your rugby league antiques on Twitter or Instagram at FanFoxLeague.